Let's work through a mean value theorem finding the C type of problem. So here are the directions. Determine whether the mean value theorem applies to f of x equals e to the x on the closed interval from 0 to natural log of 7. If so, find the point or points guaranteed by the mean value theorem. Okay, so first of all, we're instructed to determine whether the mean value theorem applies in this situation. So, what are the criteria for the mean value theorem to apply? Well, for the mean value theorem to apply on some interval, the function has to be continuous on that closed interval and differentiable on the open interval. Well, what's our function in this case? Our function is e to the x, and e to the x is continuous and differentiable on its entire domain, which is all real numbers. So therefore, the mean value theorem would apply in this case. So let me write this out in words for us. So in response to this first question here, the mean value theorem applies because f of x equals e to the x is continuous on the closed interval from 0 to natural log of 7. So it's continuous everywhere and specifically on that interval. And differentiable on the closed interval from 0 to natural log of 7. So once again, e to the x is differentiable everywhere, so it's definitely differentiable on the interval we're interested in. Okay, so this would be the kind of thing you would write down in response to a question like, does the mean value theorem apply? So the second part of the question then is to find the point or points guaranteed by the mean value theorem. Okay, so because of this first bullet point I've written down, because the mean value theorem does apply, these criteria are met, then I know, so thus, there is a C such that F prime of C equals F of B minus F of A over B minus A. Okay, so because those criteria are met, I know that there's a C such that this relationship is true, and the question wants me to actually calculate what that C is. All right, so how do we set about doing that? Well, it's pretty much a plug and chug problem from this point on. So I know my interval is from 0 to natural log of 7. So 0 is my A and natural log of 7 is my B. So I want to plug in those points. So f of b becomes f of natural log 7. F of a is f of 0. And then on the bottom I have natural log 7 minus 0. And remember, my function was e to the x. So I want to use that information as well. So if I plug that in, I get e to the natural log of 7, right? I'm evaluating my function at the point natural log of 7, minus e to the 0 over natural log of 7 minus 0. Okay, so if I simplify that, what's e to the natural log of 7? Well, e and natural log are inverse functions, so that's just 7. E to the 0 is 1. Anything to the 0 power is 1. And then I get natural log of 7 in the bottom, so this becomes 6 over natural log of 7. Okay, so I'm looking for the point where the derivative equals the 6 over the natural log of 7. Well, to continue, I actually need to know what the derivative of my function is. I haven't yet calculated that derivative. So if f of x equals e to the x, then what's f prime of x? Well, the derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. So the derivative is e to the x, so I want to find the point, the value, where e to the x equals 6 over ln 7. So now I just need to solve this relationship for x. Okay, so I have e to the x. X is in the exponent. So how can I actually solve this expression for x? Well, a very useful trick is to take the natural log of both sides. It's going to make things work out really nicely in this case. Because what happens then is on the left-hand side, I have the natural log of e to the x. But because a natural log and e are inverses, I'm just left with x on the left-hand side. So I get x equals the natural log of 6 over the natural log of 7. This is what I was looking for. If you like, we can just go ahead and call this c. This is the c guaranteed by the mean value theorem. And this is the x value at which the slope of the secant line between x equals 0 and x equals ln 7 equals the slope of the tangent line.